Hello everyone, welcome to edupediaworld.com. This is your video lecturer Vomika Soni, and in this video lecture I will explain about structure and function of root. In my previous video lecture I had already discussed about plant physiology. I have given a brief introduction to plant physiology. For all those who have not seen my previous video lecture, I strongly recommend you all to do so. In the current video lecture, the topics that will be explained are structure and function of root, role of water and minerals in plant, root hairs and their features. Hope you will enjoy this video lecture and understand the concept properly. So let's begin. Roots. They are extensively branched plant part ending in millions of root tips through which the roots absorb water. Almost all plants grow in soil. If plant roots are cut and derooted and then the plant is fixed back into the soil, the plant would slowly dry up and die. Roots have the following distinct zones like root cap, meristematic region, region of cell enlargement and root hair zone. In this you can see the structure of root. Look at these root hairs. They take in water and mineral salts. Look at this cortex. It stores some food as starch. Phloem brings food from the leaves, which is used to make new cells at the root tip. This is the phloem. Xylem, as you can see in the figure, it carries water and mineral salts up the stem. This is the root cap, which protects the root tip as it grows through the soil. And this is the root tip, which is protected by the root cap. Root tip grows as the cell divides. There are some main functions of roots which I'll be telling you. Roots are involved with the fixation of the plant to the soil. Roots absorb water and mineral nutrient from the soil. This is a very important point because water and minerals are absorbed with the help of roots from the soil where they fix the plant. Then roots conduct absorbed water and mineral nutrients to the upper parts of the plant through xylem. See, after absorbing water and mineral, it is important for the roots to further conduct all this material to rest of the parts of the plant. Roots are able to perform this activity with the help of xylem. What they do? They conduct absorbed water and mineral nutrients to the upper parts of the plant through xylem. Role of water and minerals in plant. At least 70% of the mass of a plant is composed of water, and over 90% of the water taken in by the roots passes right through the stem and out through the leaves as water vapor. The plants uses water for transportation and to maintain a high enough water pressure within its cell to support itself. Besides this, water is used up by the plant for several other purposes also. What are these purposes? I will explain one by one. The first purpose is transportation. Water is a suitable transport medium which causes transportation of substances in solution from roots upward to the shoot or from leaves to the other parts. Next is photosynthesis. Water is used as a raw material in the synthesis of glucose. The third purpose is mechanical function. Water provides turgidity, which is necessary for stiffness of plant tissues. As you can see in this figure, this is a turgid cell from a leaf with enough water. And this is a flaccid cell from a leaf with no water. With this figure, you can imagine the importance of water in plant. Next is transpiration. A large quantity of water is passed out as a vapor during transpiration. These all were the purposes in which water is used up by the plant. Next, we will discuss about minerals. Role of minerals in plants. Minerals act as building blocks for many compounds synthesized by plants. These are required by the plants as constituents of cell and cell organelles, as well as synthesis of variety of compounds required by the cell. So, minerals are building blocks for many compounds and they help in the synthesis of variety of other compounds as well, which are required by the cell in several activities. Also, the mineral nutrients are absorbed by the roots only. This is a very important point to notice, that the mineral nutrients are absorbed only by the roots. Okay. Next, we will discuss about root hairs and their features. See, root hairs are thin, they are very delicate, unicellular, prolongations of epiblema. Now, what do you mean by epiblema? Epiblema are the epidermal cells of rootlets, specially adapted to absorb liquids. Okay. In this image, you can see a germinated seed which is showing so small, delicate and thin root hairs. Root hairs are very, very thin. The cell wall of the root hairs are made up of two layers, the outer layer of pectin and inner layer of cellulose. The cell wall of the root hair acts as a permeable membrane. Then it is followed by cell membrane, which is semi-permeable. This membrane encloses cytoplasm, nucleus and vacuole. So this was the root hair structure. In this image, you can notice the path that is taken by the water molecules from the soil to the root hair. See, these are the root hair and these arrows that are visible, these are the direction of water. The water entering the root hair. This is the cell membrane. This is the cellulose cell wall. Here you can see the cytoplasm. This is the vacuole and this is the nucleus. This is root xylem. So, water that is entering in the root hair, it moves through cytoplasm, through the cell wall, and finally it reaches the root xylem. This is the path that is taken by water molecules from the soil through the root hair. This was all for today's video lecture. In the upcoming video lecture, I will describe about absorption and conduction of water involving different processes. Till then, keep watching to the Edupedia World videos and have a wonderful day ahead.